grandchildren and to my great-grandchildren, who for some day in the future may be interested in how Noreen and I settled in Belvedere back in 1946. It all began when I first fell in love with the Tiburon Peninsula. I lived in Oakland with my father, Harry, and my mother, Edna. And my sisters, Jerry and Jeanette. Oh. On Sundays, my parents would let us take turns choosing where to go on a picnic. When it was my turn, I would often ask to go to Belvedere and Tiburon. This is a picture of what Tiburon and Belvedere looked like back in the 20s. The big attraction was the dirt road that went from Highway 101 past the old dairy ranches, which there were two on the highway into Belvedere. And my parents would let me climb the trees and eat my lunch in the branches. Probably doesn't sound much fun to you, but it was great fun for me in those old days. He let me walk across the old train trestle that over the train yard, and we'd watch the engines turn around at the roundhouse. Little did I dream that someday, 25 years later, I'd be walking my own son across the same train trestle. Here's a shot of the old roundhouse. You'll notice there are 10 engines in there. They would position themselves and get onto a round table to turn around to go back up to Eureka. Very, very interesting that that was still in operation when we came to live in Belvedere in 1946. To get to Tiburon in those days, we drove along Centerfell Avenue in Belvedere to Beach Road and then across the drawbridge which separated the lagoon from the cove, then on to Main Street. The town of Tiburon was like an old frontier town with dirt streets and old wooden buildings, most of which have since burned down. My Aunt Tilly and Niels Anderson managed the old Tiburon Hotel and had a mercantile store with Mr. Chapman at the east end of Main Street, which we used to visit. You can see the old Tiburon Hotel here. It was fascinating to watch the old sailing vessels bringing their catch to the cod fishery on the west shore of Belvedere. Now, when the war was over, back in 1945, I got out of the Navy, got a job in advertising, bought a home under construction over in Lameda Park, now called Millbrae. The price was $7,250. It was not what we wanted, but we could afford the loan payments, which were $75 a month. Before the house was completed, I took Doreen to Belvedere, and she fell in love with it. We purchased a lot at 40 Bella Vista with workable financing from Dave and Harry Allen at the Belvedere Land Company, priced $2,250. I set forth drawing plans and building a model of our dream house. We put the plans out to bid with a contractor. The first bid was $14,000, way, way over our budget. I offered to do the painting and the woodwork, but the price kept going up because of inflation. With the plans and the bill of materials in hand, I told Doreen I would build it myself. She thought I was crazy, but agreed it was the only way we could afford it. I bought a popular mechanics book, How to Build Your Own House. We sold our Lameda Park house, took the profit, and moved into the Hillerita Housing Project in Tiburon for $25 a month with Ronnie and Bill. We cut down 20 trees. Had a bulldozer cut a shelf on the hillside for the house. We built the forms, poured the concrete, worked every day after my office job until about 11 p.m. with floodlights. One morning, when I got on the bus to go to work in the city, I said good morning to the gentleman sitting next to me. He said, it would be a good morning if that SOB would stop hammering and sawing on his house all night. Noreen took care of the kids, brought me my meals, helped with the two-man jobs. My best friend Jack Rands and Noreen's father Ray helped on several Saturdays and Sundays. I worked together with my plumber friend Tom Eubanks and the electrician Bill Seville. We hired a glass man to install the large sheets of glass and a roofer to do the tar and gravel. After about 6 months, we moved into the basement while we were still framing the upstairs. We hung sheets to divide the rooms while the sawdust settled all over our beds. Within a year, the house was livable, but we never stopped working on it for 34 years. Now I'm living in Posey's house and haven't stopped working on it for about 16 years. During our 34 years together in Belvedere, we raised three beautiful children, Ronnie, Bill, and Debbie. This is a photograph of one of our Christmas cards showing the three families. It was Ronnie and her husband and the two children, Rob and Heather. And there was Bill and his wife and their two children, Billy and Mark. Along with Debbie. Okay, we were involved in all the usual activities growing up in a small community. We put on fundraisers, like the annual variety shows, started the co-players with all their drama performances, got involved with the PTA, Cub Scouts, and Brownies. Helped build the Tiburon Peninsula Rec Center, which is now called the Tiburon Peninsula Club. Founded the Marin Swim League. Attended and officiated in the children's sporting activities. Belvedere was indeed a good life. The following pictures, taken over many years, depict some of the great charm and grace of my love affair with Belvedere. The China Cabin on the Belvedere Cove has two lovely benches on the deck in memory of Noreen, who shared with me the beauty of Belvedere. Following this, I want to show a movie of the house, the way it looks now, after it was remodeled by Buck and Marilyn Bradley in 1983. And I think that tells my story, and I hope you enjoyed the picture. I hope you will enjoy the pictures to show that he was... Oh,
God. It's the good life, full of fun, seems to be the ideal. Yes, the good life lets you hide all the sadness you feel. You won't really fall in love, 'cause you can't take the chance. So be honest with yourself, don't try to fake romance. It's the good life to be free and explore the unknown. Like the heartaches when you learn you must face them alone. Please remember, I still want you. And in case you wonder why, well, just wake up, kiss that good life. Remember, I still want you. And in case you wonder why, well, just wake up, kiss that good life goodbye.
Turn around and it's summer Next day you turn around and it's fall, and the springs and the winters of a lifetime, whatever happened to them all? As a man who has always had the wandering ways, now I'm reaching back for yesterday, till a long forgotten love appears, and I find that I'm sighing softly as I near September. The warm September of my years. As a man who has never paused at wishing wells, now I'm watching children's carousels and their laughter's music to my ears. And I find that I'm smiling gently as I'm near September, the warm September of my years. The golden warm September of
life, full of fun, seems to be the ideal. Yes, the good life lets you hide all the sadness you feel. You won't really fall in love, 'cause you can't take the chance. So be honest with yourself, don't try to fake romance. It's the good life to be free and explore the unknown. Like the heartaches, when you learn, you must face them alone. Please remember, I still want you. And in case you wonder why, well, just wake up, kiss that good life goodbye. Remember, I still want you. And in case you wonder why, well, just us wake up, kiss that good life goodbye.
Love laughs at a king. Kings don't mean a thing on the street of dreams. Dreams broken in two can be made like new on the street of dreams. Gold, silver, and all you can hold up there on a moonbeam. Poor, ain't nobody poor, long as love is sure on the street of dreams. Rubies are more. Love is sure.
It's Tuesday, December the 17th, 1996. I'm standing here in Judge Field by the Tiburon Recreation Center, looking up at the little church up on the hill where Debbie and Darryl were married. I'm going to take you around and show you some other sites, but I've got to hurry up because it's only 1 week till Christmas and I want to get this film finished for you. I know it's kind of corny. It was kind of a put-together job, but at least you'll see what things were like way back in the 20s and from the 40s, the 50s, 60s, 70s. Wow, it's been a long time, and I've loved every minute of it. And here's that little church right up close, right where they were married. Here's another little close-up shot of the church, just from another angle. Now here's some pictures taken of Belvedere as it looks now across the water. And I'll pan across here slowly so you can see the Corinthian Yacht Club sticking out over the end of the of Corinthian Island, and Belvedere Island in the back. And here comes Main Street with all the shops and the restaurants, like Guaymas here at the end. And there's the path going down in front of the road by the waterfront. Tamalpais way back up in the background there. Here's the way Main Street looks today after about 75 years from the first time I showed you these pictures. And this, looking down the street, and I hope I'm recording. Town was painted over many years. back there at the end is where my Aunt Tilly and Uncle Nels had their, they managed the hotel, the old Tiburon Hotel. Anyway, here's Main Street the way it looks today. Here's a shot of the old China Cabin. This was the salon that was on top of the old China, which was a stern paddle wheel ship, side wheeler sailor that went from San Francisco to Yokohama and Hong Kong. It was taken off by a gentleman to be used as a summer weekend cottage on the shore, and for over 100 years this salon and additions of a bedroom and bathrooms and so forth were used by tenants up until about 10 years ago when the Landmark Society decided to restore it. And this is the way it looks today. It's a beautiful building. So happens that I have the privilege of being a docent there once a month, tell people all about it. And this is the place where Noreen's two benches are there in her dedication. Here we are back in Belvedere, 1996, December the 17th. Here's the house that Bill and Noreen built. It's the house where Debbie was born, where Bill and Ronnie grew up. And Brad, or Buck and Marilyn Bradley bought it, and they took all the redwood off and shingled the outside, as you can see. Here's the pool in the front yard. Had a lot of fun in here. Just get down here and show you this on the deck and around of the house. This is a nice addition that the Bradleys made to the side of the house, a little sitting area. And move along here to the front door. And all the way around. Oh, the gardener's just arrived to do some work. Here's an addition that they built in the back of the house where the deck was. They extended the deck out and added this stellarium to the living room, which is a very nice addition. This is the deck off the bedroom. They've expanded that as well. They did some nice work here and made the place very, very livable. There's Angel Island out there. Berkeley way off in the background. There's Tiburon. The lagoon down below. That's the kitchen in there from the deck. Looking out over the deck again to Richardson Bay in the background, the hills of Tiburon. All those houses have been built since we were here. When we first came, it was just cows up in those hills. Kind of fun to come back here and see what it's like. We built this house in 1946. So, this is the end of my love affair story about Belvedere for the past 75 years. Plus the story of our Belvedere home for the last 50 years. Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. It's been a good life. That's it.
good life, full of fun, seems to be the ideal. Yes, the good life lets you hide all the sadness you feel.